This girl has a weird case. She activates electricity to her body to calm herself down. This controls her anger in public, because when she doesn't, she easily gets enraged and releases extreme power, making her a menace to society. Hello, welcome back to I Am Movies. Today we're diving into the 2021 action suspense movie known as Jolt. But before we jump into the details, make sure to show us some love by liking the video and subscribing to the channel. Now, let's get right into it. The movie begins with Lindy Lewis, a quiet girl who sometimes seems adorable, but she has a hidden problem called an impulse control issue in her DNA. During a birthday celebration, a boy takes her cake, and Lindy, unable to control her anger, slams his head into the cake, surprising everyone. As Lindy grows up, her rage intensifies at minor incidents. While waiting at the hospital, her worsening condition becomes evident. The doctor diagnoses her with intermittent explosive disorder, recommending transferring guardianship to her parents for safety. Isolated from others, Lindy's disorder makes living in the world unsafe for her and those around her. She's confined in a padded room, observed by doctors. Her body's high cortisol levels make her stronger and faster, highlighting the urgent need for a cure. The nurse takes Lindy outside, but she gets upset and breaks the rope in her hand. Lindy then beats up a nurse. As a result, the doctors decided to send her to a military camp. In the camp, she wins all her fights and doesn't stop even when the whistle is blown. Soldiers cheer as she's pulled away from her opponents. However, Lindy loses her temper, attacks the commanding officer in charge, and is sent back to the hospital. Finally, a solution is found by the doctor, an electrode vest with a button to push whenever Lindy starts getting angry. This vest with electrodes helps control her temper by allowing her to push a button when she feels upset. Months later, she tries to live a normal life. On her way to the restaurant with her date, Justin, Lindy witnesses a man scolding the valet parking girl for being slow to find a customer's key. This angers Lindy, and she imagines what she would do to him. To calm herself, she activates a shock vest she's wearing, and she instantly calms herself down. Despite her mood being affected, Lindy decides to enter the restaurant. However, during their date, Lindy's mood is further ruined when they encounter a rude waitress. Lindy, feeling upset, activates the shock vest again to calm herself down. She then excuses herself to the restroom. In the restroom, Lindy overhears the waitress making fun of Justin. Trying to use her device, she finds it less effective. Just before leaving, the waitress says something that enrages Lindy. Storming into the waitress's space, Lindy bangs her head against the wall. The waitress passes out and Lindy disappears into the crowd without informing Justin. Meanwhile, Justin sits alone at the table waiting for Lindy. He goes to the door, but he can't see her outside. Lindy's impulsive actions have left Justin in confusion and waiting. When Lindy gets back to her apartment, she takes off her clothes, revealing the electrode-lined vest she is wearing. On the second day, Lindy visits Dr. Ivan Munchen to fix the electrode-lined vest. As soon as she enters the office, Dr. Ivan takes out his gun and points it at her, warning Lindy to put on handcuffs and stay away from him. Dr. Ivan is aware of Lindy's explosive disorder and takes safety measures. As Dr. Ivan taps on his table, Lindy envisions brutally hurting him, but realizes she needs his help. Despite her anger, she fights to contain it. Dr. Ivan suggests Lindy start a relationship, but she fears she might harm the man. He throws her the key to unlock the handcuffs, increases the voltage, and warns her about the limits of the human body. Dr. Ivan believes a close human connection is the solution to her problems. Lindy denies his advice, but is told not to run away from someone she feels a connection with. She leaves, saying they'll meet again next week. Later, when Lindy travels on the train, a man sitting next to her deliberately tries to crowd her out, and she hits him in the face. In their next meeting, Justin expresses happiness that Lindy called him for their second date. They discuss their lives, and Justin shares that he works as an accountant for a private company, owned by a guy named Barry. Lindy reveals she used to work in security as a bouncer in a not-so-great bar but got fired, insisting it wasn't her fault. She expresses her dream of becoming a photographer. Back at Lindy's place, they kiss, but Lindy stops, worried she might hurt Justin during intimacy. Justin reassures her, saying he's not scared, and they share a passionate night together. The next morning, Justin gives Lindy a gift, a camera, as she had mentioned her hobby of photography the night before. As Lindy thanks him for the gift, Justin asks about her medical equipment, and she reluctantly shares about her impulse control problem. When Justin asks Lindy if she has tried meditation, she shares that she has tried various things like yoga, meditation, and extreme sports, but none of them proved helpful. Despite Lindy's request for Justin to stay longer, he explains he must go back to his job as an accountant and leaves after inviting her to dinner at his house. Excited about the invitation, Lindy updates Dr. Ivan about her successful date, believing that Justin could help her overcome her disorder. Lindy confidently expresses that she won't need the device anymore, indicating her deep feelings for Justin. The same day, Lindy visits her doctor, and she is happy to inform her she did not use her device when she spent her night with Justin. Dr. Ivan is concerned that love might blind Lindy and lead her into trouble, but Lindy, caught up in her emotions, kisses him goodbye and dismisses his worries. After visiting the doctor, Lindy spends the day taking pictures with her new camera. As she gets ready for dinner at night, she receives a message from Justin, informing her that he will be late. Later that night, Lindy calls Justin, but the phone is answered by Detective Vickers. She is shocked to know that Justin is dead. She rushes to the police station, where Detectives Vickers and Niven inform her that Justin's dead body was found in a dumpster, with two gunshot wounds to his forehead. Lindy requests to see Justin one last time, but her request is denied. Enraged by the denial, Lindy imagines punching Vickers but manages to stop herself with the electric shock. Leaving the police station, Lindy attends Justin's funeral as the sole mourner. Grieving, she remembers their brief happy time together, and her anger begins to spiral out of control. In frustration, Lindy meets Dr. Ivan and aggressively pins him to the table, expressing her anger over Justin's death. Dr. Ivan is almost crushed by her violence. Lindy tries to use the vest button, but the electric shock is no longer effective, so Dr. Ivan gives her a sedative jab. After waking up, Lindy is still in disbelief about Justin's sudden death and suspects that Justin's boss, Barry, may be related to the murder. Dr. Ivan tries to divert Lindy's thoughts and urges her to let the police handle the investigation. However, Lindy is determined to take matters into her own hands. Despite Dr. Ivan's attempts to stop her, fearing she might harm someone, Lindy leaves the clinic, threatening him as she proceeds with her plan. Lindy urgently contacts Detective Vickers, persuading him to come to her residence. Subsequently, she covertly infiltrates the police station to pilfer crucial murder case documents. In a bizarre turn of events, Lindy finds herself revisiting memories of an intense encounter with her odorous ex, Justin, evoking passionate emotions. Recognizing the rising violence within her, she activates a cooling vest to regain control. Rifling through Justin's wallet, Lindy discovers Vickers' address and ventures to his apartment in search of clues. Mid-investigation, Vickers contacts her, reprimanding Lindy for trespassing in his office. Despite his partner's inclination to arrest her, Vickers extends a second chance and discloses Detective Nevin's impending arrival. In the midst of negotiations with the police, Lindy seizes an opportunity, overpowering her adversaries and making a daring escape. As Lindy flees to the basement garage, she commandeers Justin's McLaren sports car, initiating a high-stakes car chase. The pursuit unfolds, culminating in an injury to Detective Vickers while Lindy manages to elude capture. The next morning, Lindy visits a mobile store and requests the manager's assistance in connecting her with a hacker. He introduces her to Andy. Lindy employs the services of the hacker to breach Justin's cell phone, discovering that the last 7 incoming calls originated from an abandoned building in the CBD area. These calls, she learns, are from Barry, a renowned ammunition merchant, unveiling Justin's unexpected involvement in a complex world. Despite the hacker deeming Lindy's payment excessively steep, she rewards the hacker with the key of the sports car. Subsequently, Lindy ventures to the abandoned building, where Barry oversees an underground fight. Navigating through the crowd, she confronts Barry amidst the 2 men in combat. Inquiring about Justin's demise, Lindy challenges Barry. If she defeats 3 of his top fighters, he must disclose the identity of the killer. Barry, intrigued, agrees to the proposition. Selecting 3 formidable opponents, Barry announces a no-rules simultaneous battle. Undaunted, Lindy embraces the challenge and engages in a ferocious fight, systematically incapacitating each adversary. The crowd cheers as Lindy emerges victorious, leaving Barry impressed. He declares the end of the fight, instructing everyone to disperse. After emerging victorious in the fight, Lindy and Barry embark on a car journey. However, Barry reveals his untrustworthiness, admitting he has never been true to his word. In a sudden twist, his driver brandishes a gun at Lindy, triggering her to lose control and overpower both of them. Lindy takes charge, threatening to shock Barry as he sprawls spread-eagled on the car engine, and she presses him for information. As Lindy repeats her question, Barry confesses that his boss, Gareth Fizel, was responsible for Justin's demise. However, he warns Lindy that locating Fizel would be nearly impossible, given his influential status and the government's reluctance to pursue him. Simultaneously, Detective Nevins updates Vickers at the hospital about Lindy's history of violence and assault, linked to her anger issues. Lindy later visits Detective Vickers, expressing gratitude for the opportunity to set things right. She discloses her discovery about Fizel killing Justin, prompting Vickers to inquire about proof. Lindy learns that Fizel is a billionaire recluse involved in illegal activities, making him seemingly untouchable. Despite the challenges, Vickers provides Lindy with Fazel's downtown address. Their conversation is interrupted by Detective Nevins, leading to a chase through the hospital to the maternity ward. Lindy, struggling to contain her anger, shocks herself to regain composure. In the midst of the chaos, Detective Nevins confronts Lindy, brandishing her gun and warning her not to move. Undeterred, Lindy improvises by throwing baby dolls at Detective Nevins to impede her pursuit, allowing Lindy to make a daring escape. Lindy reaches Fizel's office building, where Delacroix, the security head, agrees to escort her, but knocks her down in the elevator. She regains consciousness in a clinical white basement, tied to a chair with her vest removed. Delacroix questions the purpose of the electrode vest, and Lindy explains it's essential for her heart condition. Despite her plea, he confiscates the vest, threatens her life, and sends her back to her apartment in a car, informing Fizelle about her inquiries regarding an accountant. In the car, Lindy misses her vest and asks the driver to stop, but resorts to attacking him when he refuses. The ensuing struggle leads to an accident, but Lindy manages to escape the vehicle. Desperate for a new electrode vest, Lindy rushes to Dr. Ivan's office. Upon seeing Lindy in distress, Dr. Ivan reaches for his gun but assures her he can create a replacement vest. However, he implores Lindy to cease her pursuit of Fizelle. Lindy arrives at her apartment, discovering a subtle but significant change. Her door number has shifted, signaling an unwelcome visitor. Suspicion escalating, she enters through a window, only to stumble upon an explosive trap set by Fizzle's henchmen. With quick thinking, Lindy disarms the device, preserving it for future use. Taking a daring turn, she sets a chain reaction in motion by activating the gas and placing a foil-wrapped device in the microwave, setting a timer for 20 minutes before making a swift exit. Outside, she encounters Detective Vickers, who is oblivious to the impending danger. In a tense encounter, Lindy manages to persuade him not to arrest her. Meanwhile, her apartment succumbs to the explosive scheme. Determined, Lindy ascends Fizelle's building, reaching its zenith where she confronts Delacroix. Their exchange is brief and marked by Lindy's insolence, earning her a punishing blow to the head. Regaining consciousness in an ominous white room again, Lindy finds herself at Delacroix's mercy. As he attempts to drain her blood, she breaks free from her restraints, retaliating by knocking Delacroix to the ground. In a vengeful response, he hangs her up and subjects her to a brutal whipping. Undeterred, Lindy fights back fiercely, delivering a decisive kick to Delacroix's vulnerable region and incapacitating him instantly. Emerging from the white room, Lindy faces an ambush by more adversaries. Unfazed, she skillfully employs a fire extinguisher, dispatching several opponents with calculated precision. Displaying her combat prowess, Lindy even takes down an assailant with a lethal neckbreak move. Overcoming all obstacles, Lindy reaches Fizelle's office, only to discover his lifeless form. A twist in the movie that raises more questions than answers. Suddenly, Justin appears and claps for Lindy's revenge. Lindy is shocked because she thought Justin was dead. It turns out that Justin funded the research on Lindy and worked with Dr. Ivan to involve her in a plan to kill Fizelle. Lindy, realizing she has been betrayed, cries for the man she thought she missed. In a fit of rage, Lindy tries to kill Justin, but he reveals a modified vest by Dr. Ivan that paralyzes her with electric shocks. Justin sadistically enjoys tormenting Lindy, repeatedly pressing the button to torture her. To him, Lindy is just a tool and an experiment. But as Lindy gradually adapting to the shock, Lindy slowly regains strength, but instead of fighting Justin, she throws a bag at him and runs the office. Unbeknownst to Justin, the bag contains a bomb. As Lindy exits, she activates the bomb, blowing Justin inside. In Dr. Ivan's office, Lindy confronts him, intending to kill him for his betrayal. However, Detectives Vickers and Nevin arrives. Vickers, misunderstanding the situation, shoots Lindy in the leg, but Lindy is just putting handcuffs at Dr. Ivan. At the city hospital, Lindy claims self-defense, but Nevin informs her she'll face charges for her attack. After Nevin leaves, Vickers returns Lindy's vest and camera, apologizing with a dinner invitation. Lindy returns to her burned apartment and finds a mysterious woman. In a flashback, she remembers the woman as a doctor, from Lindy's past experiments. This woman tries to recruit Lindy for an unnamed organization. Through their system, Lindy can learn to harness her rage and target the right people. But before Lindy can respond, the woman activates an electroshock remote, hinting more to come in a sequel. If you'd like to see us recap any other movies or topics you have in mind, just drop a comment and let us know. And don't forget to hit the like button, share this recap, and subscribe to stay updated for the next one. Until next time.